Dear students, in today's lecture, let's make an attempt to know about integrated pest management of silkworm woozy fly. Introduction. Integrated management concept came to be applied in tackling pest problem of agriculture about a few decades ago, especially after realizing the undesirable after effects of continued and discriminate use of pesticides in the production of crops. In this approach, several control strategies are integrated so that each strategy contributes towards reducing the pest load, and in total, a satisfactory control is achieved without harming our environment and other beneficial organisms. Similarly, in woozy fly management also, IPM is evolved and is being implemented successfully so as to achieve sustainability in silkworm cocoon crop production. The woozy fly Exorista bombyensis is a serious endolarval parasitoid of the silkworm Bombyx mori, inflicting 10 to 12% damage to silkworm cocoon crop in the premier silk producing states of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh, which accounts for about 80% of raw silk production in the country. Besides, in the northern traditional sericulture states of West Bengal also, an annual cocoon crop loss of 15 to 20% has been reported due to this fly pest. Similarly, the loss in the tropical tussar crops was to the tune of about 30 to 40% due to infestation of Exorista bombyensis, where the silkworm are non-domesticated and reared outside. The entry of the woozy fly into most prosperous sericulture areas of South India during 1980 triggered intensive research efforts to contain this menace. They are blackish gray in color, measuring about 12 mm in length, with the male being gently bigger in size compared to females. The males can be distinguished from the females by the presence of an external brownish or orange genitalia covered with blackish hair on the ventral side of the abdomen tip. The female takes cue from mulberry for searching or reaching the host. Period of occurrence occurs throughout the year, however, more common during rainy season followed by winter and summer. Life cycle of woozy fly. A gravid female woozy fly lays about 400 to 500 eggs on the silkworm larvae, but on an average it lays 200 to 300. However, on daily basis it lays about 20 to 30 eggs per day at the rate of 1 or 2 eggs only on a single larva. The tiny eggs are glued mostly onto the intersegmental regions of the silkworm body. The eggs hatch in about 1.5 or 2 days, and the maggots bore directly into the silkworm body at the point of attach of the egg. Finally, a black scar appears at the place of entry. By staying inside the silkworm larvae, it feeds on the internal contents for about 6 to 8 days, during which it undergoes two molts. Later, it comes out by burst opening the host body and peppered with 12 to 20 hours in dark places like cracks, crevices and loose soil. From the pupa, the adult woozy fly emerges in about 10 to 12 days, thus the life cycle is completed in about 20 to 22 days. About male woozy fly lives for about 10 to 18 days, whereas the females for about 18 to 22 days, which feeds on the nectar, pollen grains and rotten fruits. Types of damage and symptoms. After the hatching of woozy fly eggs, since the maggot enter directly into the body of the silkworm by burrowing, it results in the appearance of a black scar or black spot at the point of entry. From this, one can identify the woozy fly attack in silkworm rearing. One more symptom is that the silkworm larvae is killed due to feeding of internal content by the woozy maggot. If the oviposition by the woozy fly takes place during final instar of silkworm rearing, then the Wuji maggot will come out by boring the silicon cocoon, undergo pupation outside. Inside the bivotin cocoons, where the cocoon shell is very hard, the fully grown maggot cannot cut open the hard shell, and hence it pupates inside, emerge as adult fly inside and die there itself. But the same will be treated as melt cocoon, which fetches low rate in the cocoon market. Integrated pest management. Integrated pest management is a system which utilizes all suitable pest suppression techniques in as much compatible manner as possible in order to keep or maintain the pest populations below these causing economic injury. IPM of Wuji fly. Various integrated pest management strategies have been evolved for the management of the Wuji fly Exorista bombyensis. These strategies can be classified into the following groups. Number 1, cultural or mechanical method. Cultural methods are categorized by their simplicity, less cost or no cost evolvement, eco-friendly and easy to be adapted by sericulturists. Several cultural methods are recommended from time and again depending upon the stage of the crop and status of the pest. These methods includes collection of Wuji infested silkworm from silkworm rearing house and their destruction by burning or by dipping them in 0.5% soap solution. Keep the floor of the silkworm rearing house tight or firm or free from cracks and crevices so as to see that Wuji maggots will not get a suitable place for pupation, and therefore such maggots or puparia can be collected easily and destroyed. In cocoon markets and drilling establishment also, plug the cracks and crevices in the floor so that the maggots are deprived of these places for pupation. Collection of maggots and pupae of Wuji fly from cocoon markets, drainages and drilling establishments and their destruction by burning or by dipping them in 0.5% soap solution. Wuji infested larvae, especially these infested in 15 stars, spin cocoons a day or 2 earlier than uninfested larvae. Such infested larvae have to be mounted separately and cocoons spun by them should be stifled immediately in order to kill the maggots before the flies emerges from them. The sands or soil burn should be often examined for the collection of maggots and puparia, and they should be destroyed. Placing the mounting indoors at the time of spinning so that the Wuji maggots recovering from infested spinning larvae can be collected and destroyed. Sorting of the Wuji pierced cocoon before transportation to the cocoon market helps in preventing further spread of the Wuji maggots during transportation, besides fetching higher price for the good cocoon lot which is free from Wuji pierced cocoons. All the farmers of one village should rear silkworm at one time, that is follow batch brushing, so that multiplication of Wuji will be kept at low and there should be a minimum gap of 20 days from one rearing to another rearing. Number 2, exclusion method. As the name itself implies, this method involves an effort to include the Wuji fly from silkworm rearing house or rendering the silkworm larvae inaccessible to the ovipositing females of Wuji fly by creating certain mechanical barriers as follows. Fixing of wire mesh or nylon net to the doors and windows of the rearing house. This is one of the first methods suggested for the suppression of Wuji fly in silkworm crops. Using a nylon net closure to the silkworm rearing stand is another method of keeping away the adults of Wuji fly. In a rearing house, an area for silkworm rearing is unmarked and protected from all sides as also the top with fly-proof nylon net, keeping a minimum of 2 to 3 feet distance from all sides of the rearing stand, so that the rearing stands are completely enclosed by fly-proof nylon net cover, including some extra space for feeding, bed cleaning, etc. The nylon net is more economical, durable and convenient in handling during in disinfection and drying. Rearing of silkworm under nylon net partition reduces Ooze infestation to about 2.87% as against 11.27% in general rearing houses. Consequently, this device helps in increasing the cocoon yield by 4 to 12 kgs per 100 DFLs. Provide a small anteroom in the entrance of rearing house to prevent direct entry of Ooze fly inside the rearing house. Provide automatic doors closing mechanism. Third one, physical methods. In this method, the role of light, color or chemicals in attracting or repelling or acting as physical barrier has been exploited. The physical method developed for the management of Ooze fly are light cum sticky trap. Like any other insect, Ooze fly also gets attracted towards light. A source of light in the rearing room and place a sticky board below the light source will trap the adults when they stick the board. Ooze trap. It is a liquid chemo trap formulated from indigenous materials which are cost effective and environmental friendly in nature. The trap is effective in trapping and killing both the sexes of Ooze fly, which is a very important step towards the effective management of the Ooze fly. The behavior of attraction of Ooze fly towards yellow color is exploited in this method. Mode of use. 1 tablet is dissolved in 1 liter of water to get deep yellow colored solution. Keep this solution in white trays and place them both inside and outside the rearing house near doors and windows at window height. Use Ooze trap solution starting from 13 star through spinning stage of silkworm rearing for effective catch of the Ooze fly. Mode of action. Gravid female Ooze flies enter the rearing house in search of silkworm for egg laying. Ooze fly being positively phototropic in nature frequently visits the areas where more light is available after laying a few eggs on silkworms. The placement of Ooze trap in such places helps in attraction of maximum number of flies. Yellow color of the trap solution play a significant role in attracting the Ooze fly. It is also obvious that the fly on sighting the trap solution makes hectic flight over it, fall into the solution and the fly dies within a minute. The cost benefit ratio of Ooze trap is found to be 1:35. Point to be remembered while using Ooze trap. Water free from turbidity should be used in preparing the trap solution. Pond or stagnated water should not be used. Ooze trap tablets are hygroscopic in nature and hence should be kept in closed pouches till use. Fresh solution has to be prepared every time. The trap solution should be kept only at places where more light is available. A light source such as electric bulb should be provided near the trap solution in case of insufficient light. If the room is uniformly illuminated, some dark area should be created by closing a few windows, doors or other light sources to enhance the fly trapping. The trap should be used day and night. Dark color and deep containers should not be used for placement of trap solution. The trap solution should be changed only when it becomes dirty. Advantages: Uji trap solution is safe to silicone, pets and also to human beings, as it is devoid of toxic chemicals. It is very simple to adopt and highly cost effective. Uji trap solution does not stain these vessels or human hand permanently. Number 4. Chemical methods. Due to high sensitivity of silicone to chemicals and insecticides, chemical methods have little or no relevance to the management of Uji fly. However, attempts have been made to screen certain chemicals to identify a few that possess ovicidal or megaticidal properties. Ujicide. It is a liquid ovicidal formulation of benzoic acid developed by the Central Sericulture Research and Training Institute, Mysore. The formulation has been developed with a view to kill the eggs of Uji fly before hatching. Ujicide has to be sprayed after bed cleaning on the body of silicone starting from second day of third instar through spinning stage at the rate of 5 to 6 ml per square feet on alternate days except when the silicones are under mold. About 5 to 6 liters solution of Ujicide is required for a rearing of 100 EFLs. Mode of action. Ujicide kills the eggs when it applied on Uji infested silicone, resulting in non-emergence of Uji maggots from the eggs, which in turn helps in the escape of silicone from Uji attack. Application of Ujicide is safe to silicone and does not cause any adverse effect on post-harvest operations, including drainage and reeling. The active ingredient of Ujicide is benzoic acid and it is non-hazardous to mammals and hence safer to the users. Points to be remembered while using Ujicide. Ujicide should be always be used before expiry date and crystallized Ujicide should never be used. It should be stored in an airtight container. It should be stored in a cool and dry place and out of reach of children. Any ordinary hand sprayers can be used for spraying Ujicide. Uji powder. It is a dust formulation developed by the Karnataka State Sericulture Research and Development Institute, Talagattapura, Bengaluru, to kill the eggs of the Uji fly laid on the silicone body. It is taken in muslin cloth and dusted uniformly over the silicone immediately after bed cleaning. The Uji powder is dusted at the rate of 3 gram per square feet of silicone bed starting from second day of third instar on every alternate day till initiation of spinning. Mode of action. The developing embryos get killed within the eggs when Uji powder is applied directly on the silkworms. Efficacy of the Uji powder. Under laboratory condition, 100% control has been achieved due to Uji powder application. However, in field trials using Uji powder, the incidence of Uji was 0.18% compared to 17.85% in untreated silkworm rearings. Besides this, an additional cocoon yield of 5 to 10 kg has also been obtained when Uji powder was applied without affecting the normal growth and development of silkworms. Points to be remembered while using Uji powder. Uji powder should be applied over the silkworms when they are fully exposed. It should be kept in airtight container and stored in dry and cool place. It should be kept out of reach of children. Bed disinfectants should not be applied when the Uji powder is used. Silicone litter contaminated with Uji powder should not be fed to cattle. Face mask should be used while dusting the Uji powder to avoid irritation, if any. Number 5, biological method. Biological method is desirable requirement for UG fly control in sericulture. It is an ideal form of pest management with permanent, inexpensive, non-hazardous nature with its firm basis in sound ecological principles. It is the most successful and most promising alternatives of chemical control. When successful, the utilization of native natural enemies is inexpensive and easy to multiply. It is non-hazardous means of reducing UG fly populations and maintaining them often permanently below economic threshold level. Therefore, it is essential to know the potential biocontrol agents and their biological attributes in the native natural habitat of silkworm and its host plants. In recent years, a substantial effort towards achieving biological control of UG fly Exorista bombyensis has led to recording and conducting biological studies on its parasitoids. The information enumerating from such studies assumes importance, especially because the secondary parasitoids are known to act as serious mortality factor of primary parasitoids. The parasitoids accounts for 82% of total success obtained in the biological control of insect pest against 17% and 1% in predators and pathogens respectively. Efforts by various agencies towards achieving biological control of UG fly have resulted in recording of 20 parasitoids belonging to different families of the order Hymenoptera. The parasitoids assume important status, especially in view of highly successful biological control programs demonstrated through these agents in the past 3 decades. Comparative efficacy of different parasitoids. Studies and critical analysis conducted through large scale releases in rearing houses involved 4 parasitoids of UG fly, namely Nizorynchymus, Trichopria species, Exoristobia filipinensis and Derinus species, have indicated that the Nizorynchymus possess most of the desirable characteristics of an effective natural enemy, efficient host searching ability, better synchronization of its life cycle with that of host, high degree of host specificity or preference, adequate ability of acclimatize to field conditions and possibilities of quick propagation in large numbers in the laboratory. Recommendation of Enthymus for biological control of UG fly. Enthymus is an indigenous ectopeupal parasitoid released in the rearing house when the worms are in second day of 5th instar. 2 pouches are required for 100 DFLs of silkworm rearing. From each packet, Enthymus will emerge for 10 to 12 days at the rate of 10 to 12 adults per packet. After mounting of all spinning worms, transfer the same pouches near the chandrikas. After harvesting of the cocoons, shift the same pouches near the manure pit. IPM against UG fly has been developed in the field of sericulture through integration of available control strategies such as exclusion method, physical method of using UG trap, biological control using ectopeupal parasitoid that is Nizorynchymus, and cultural method of packing litters in plastic bags and keeping for 15 days to kill UG pupae available in it. By adopting the IPM package against UG fly, the infestation can be suppressed to a great extent and the infestation level can be maintained below 2% throughout the year.